إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته All praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us yet another opportunity to be gathered here in this study cycle of ours to continue our study session in this beautiful kitab Al-Usul al-Thalatha of Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab Rahmatullahi alayhi. This is going to be our 70th lesson, today being the 28th day in the month of Shawwal 1443 after the historic hijra of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina, which is equivalent to the 29th day in the month of May 2022, the Christian era. Our last lesson was on page 70. Alaysa kadhalik. We discussed to build on it. Let us go to page 69. Let us go to page 69. And then let us read وَكَذَلِكَ كُلُّ مَا فِي الْقَلْبِ أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. Have you seen it? Page 69. وَكَذَلِكَ كُلُّ مَا فِي الْقَلْبِ مِنَ التَّقَرُّبِ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فَإِنَّهُ عِبَادَةٌ. And also كُلُّ مَا فِي الْقَلْبِ, whatever is in the heart, min at-taqarrub ila Allah azza wa jal, of seeking for nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever you do in your heart that is meant to get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fa innahu ibada, that such a thing is called ibada. Kal khawfi, for example, fear. وَالرَّجَاءُ longing, right? وَالْخَشْيَ awe, to be in awe. It's a type of fear also. وَالرَّغَبَ fervent desire. أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. That is yani وَالرَّهَبَةُ, that is dread, when you dread something. وَالتَّوَكُّل, dependence, reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal inabatu, repentance. Wal isti'anatu, and seeking for assistance. Kullu hadhihi a'mal qalb, all of these are actions of the heart. Hence, all of these things mentioned, if you do them seeking for means of nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then they are ibadah, and then you will be rewarded for doing them. And then we're going to explain in details each of this bi-idhnillah. Al-luju' ila Allahi bil-qalb, fleeing. Wa khashiyatullah, fear also, alaysa kadhalik. Wa khashiyatullah, in awe of Allah, be in awe of Allah. Wa khawfuhu, and then fearing Allah. وَالرَّغْبَةُ إِلَيْهِ وَمَحَبَّتُهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, and then loving Allah, exalted be He, towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then your truthfulness in intention, doing things for the sake of Allah, and having your intention for the sake of Allah. كُلُّ مَا فِي الْقُلُوبِ, everything that is in the heart. مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَنْوَاءِ, of all of these types of ibadah, worship, different types of worship. For huwa ibadah, all of these categories, for huwa ibadah, then it is ibadah. If you are asked what is ibadah, what are the different types of ibadah, then you can mention this also. There are parts of ibadah, there are types of ibadah, even though these are actions of the heart, but they form parts of ibadah, because ibadah takunu في القلب أليس كذلك in the heart and then also on the tongue and also جوارح the body parts وكذلك تكون العبادة على الجوارح مثل and also ibadah can be on the body parts just as you have actions of the heart that will form part of ibadah you also have actions of the body parts that are part of ibadah ar-ruku' when you go on ruku' you bow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you do in salah was sujood your prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your body parts right
yes
ruku' is your body parts in action as sujood is your body part in action wal jihad fi sabilillah and fighting in the cause of Allah fighting at jihad fi sabilillah fighting the cause of Allah wal jihadu bin nafs alaysa kadhalik
no
and then jihad bin nafs الجهاد بالنفس Do you understand?
No.
والهجرة الانتقال من بلد إلى بلد الانتقال من بلد الكفر إلى That is moving from the land of kufur to the land of Islam That also is act of ibadah, but on the body parts, because you have to move your body parts. أليس كذلك؟ وعلى القلب عفوا كل هذه عبادات بدنية. All of these are categorized under worship of the body parts. The type of worship ibadah that is being carried out by the body parts. والصيام عبادة بدنية. Fasting also is a type of ibadah that is being carried by the body. تظهر على الجوارح. It is manifest on the body parts. When you are fasting, we see you looking thirsty, right?
No.
Now, and then the weakness is manifest
yes.
on the body. فإذن العبادة تكون على اللسان therefore ibadah also can be on the tongue وعلى القلب it can also be in the heart وتكون على الجوارح also on the body parts ثم هذه العبادة تنقسم إلى عبادة بدنية وإلى عبادة مالية And then this ibadah is also subcategorized into the ibadah that entails the body part and the ibadah that entails wealth. Al-ibadatul badaniyya, the ibadah that is being carried out by the body part, here thalatha al-anwa' allati qulna takunu ala al-lisani wa ala al-jawarih wa ala al-qalbi. It is also subdivided into three categories. Which has been mentioned على اللسان وعلى الجوارح وعلى القلب وتكون مالية أليس كذلك it could also be ibadah of that entails wealth you're using your wealth to do that particular act of ibadah the other one you are using your body to do that particular act of ibadah مثل إخراج الزكاة إخراج الزكاة giving out زكاة مالية it's an act of إبادة أليس كذلك مثل الإنفاق في سبيل الله spending on the path of Allah الإنفاق وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل نعم آمنوا بالله ورسوله وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ سورة الحديد أليس كذلك الإنفاق في سبيل الله So this is an act of ibadah that is maliyah because you can't spend if you don't have wealth right? When you give out zakat, it means you have wealth. When you buy food to feed the poor, when you ta'imuna ta'ama ala hubbihi, it means you have wealth. Alaysa kadhalik? والإنفاق الإنفاق في سبيل الله وهو الإنفاق في الجهاد خصوصا that is spending in the path of Allah jihad في سبيل الله يعني equipping the Muslim army as did Uthman bin Affan during which of the expedition ما ضر عثمان ما فعل بعد اليوم which battle which battle did he, yes he equipped the entire army of the Muslims Uthman bin Affan yeah he equipped the entire Muslim army So you can see, وَهُوَ الْإِنْفَاقُ فِي الْجِهَادِ spent on the path of Allah in jihad, equipping the Muslim army, supporting the Muslim army. قال الله تعالى, Allah says, وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ And they strive on the path of Allah, فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ mostly jihad. It entails other things also, right? بأموالهم with their wealth. العبادة تكون مالية هو وأنفسهم بدنية and with their body also. Let's say physically engaged in fighting for the sake of Allah. Physically engaged in doing the acts of ibadah. Physically engaged in doing the acts of hajj. After spending money because it entails the two hajj. قدم الأموال على الأنفس. Spending with wealth preceded fighting with your body parts. فالجهاد بالمال عبادة مالية. Because even when it's ibadah of wealth, right? And when you are going out for jihad, bilmal, you need money to do it. Can any country fight to defend its territorial borders without money to buy warfare arms? Yani arsenals? You need money to be able to buy tucanas. You need money to be able to buy I'm not in that part, so I don't even know them.
Whatever for cities
jet fighters, cruise missiles, B-54, right? Hawks. الحج يتكون من عبادة بدنية وعبادة مالية. Sometimes you know it entails the two, right? It entails the two. You spend money and then you do it with your body part, with your body parts. فأداء المناسك, the Hajj rites, مناسك of Hajj. خذوا أني مناسككم, right? أو كما قال رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني the prophet is teaching us how to perform Hajj. So you ساعي بين الصفا والمروة. It's what? Your body parts, your tawaf, your ability that you have to have the means, and that means wealth is one of the major requirements, right? You have to have the means to go. So wealth. مناسك يعني الطواف والسعي والرمي الجمار stoning all of these things are what? Physical you have to pick the stones and then throw them that's physical exercise your tawaf circumambulation of the house of Allah the ancient house entails physical efforts. Your movement between Safa and Marwa entails physical movement. Alaysa kadhalik? Walwukuf bi Arafah, standing on the plains of Arafah. That's physical, right?
Yes.
Alwukuf. Walmabit bi Muzdalifah. Almabitu, passing the night over. That's the beauty of Arabic language. Go?
Yes.
Ba'at yawm as-sabt, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going out for the battle of Uhud. Sometimes back in Medina, I was privileged to go to that area where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed the night of the night of on Saturday night before he moved onward to the place of the battle itself, Al-Mabit. So you know, Muzdalifah, you move from Arafah after standing when the sun setting, you move and then you come to Muzdalifah and then you pass your night over there. You sleep, everyone, the kings and everyone, you're all in on the plains there, and then in the morning you move onwards. That entails physical activity. Ibadah badaniya, these are acts of ibadah on the body part. Amma al-infaq fihi, as for spending in this act of Hajj, accommodation, visa, alaysa kadhalik, buying ram for slaughtering, alaysa kadhalik, ibadah mahaliya, because you need to spend your money doing all of that. لِأَنَّ الْحَجَّ يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى نَفَقَ. Hajj requires spending. يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى نَفَقَ. الدُّعَاءُ أَقْسَامُهُ وَدَلِيلُهُ. الدُّعَاء, page 81. وَمِنُهُ, Sheikh is mentioning the different types of ibadah. وَمِنُهُ, he said, from among the different types of ibadah, مِن جنسية أو من تبعيضية. تبعيضية ومنه, from amongst, it's not exhaustive because you cannot be able to mention all the acts of ibadah here. So it's not exhaustive. Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah has a book written specifically on that. It's called Al-Ubudiyya. But here it says وَمِنُهُ أَدْعَاهُ مِنْ تَبْعِيدِيَّ, and from amongst the types of ibadah, acts of worship, أَدْعَاهُ. الدُّعَاء is an example of ibadah. وَالْخَوْفُ, الدُّعَاء is what? Supplication. So you can write the translation, you can write supplication, invocation, calling on Allah, الدُّعَاء. أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ, supplication, invocation, calling is an act of ibadah, invocation. وَمِنُهُ الدُّعَاءُ وَالْخَوْفُ وَاوَ الْعَطَفُ أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. وَمِنُهُ وَالْخَوْفُ, fear, that you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالرَّجَاءُ, that is hope. Ar-raja'u, hope. Don't put your hope on anyone but on Allah. Alaysa kadhalik? If you put your hopes in human beings, they are bound to disappoint you, whoever such a person is. You are hoping that is going to help you. You are hoping that is going to take you out from your difficulty. You are hoping when he disappoints, you receive the shock of your life. But Allah never disappoints. So ar-raja'u, you're hoping in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min anwa' al-ibadah. Alaysa kadhalik? Wat-tawakkul, reliance. What's another word for reliance? Mutaradifat. Reliance is what? Dependence. That is what you normally say, na tawakkul, say depend on Allah.
Yes,
But because I confused you with reliance, now you're thinking otherwise. Normally, if you're given the free chance to translate at tawakkul, you say dependence on Allah. That's it. Reliance on Allah, dependence on Allah. We're going to explain this in detail and give you the adilla Qur'aniyya, and also from the hadith of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Warraghbatu, longing. Is it longing in English? What the pronunciation is always longing for something or longing for something? Longing. Irin, yani that's a raghbatu qadai. You're longing for something. Warraghbatu, dreading. Ko? Fear kenan shi ma ko? Dread. D-R-E-A-D. That's ar-rahbatu. Wal-khushu' al-khushu'u submissiveness. Submissiveness. Al-khushu' قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ أي خَائِفُونَ سَكِنُونَ. In their salah, they are submissive to Allah. Absolute concentration. Khaifuna, with fears also. With fear. So, al-khushu' submissiveness. Humbling yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal-khashya. Al-khashya. Awe. You're in awe of Allah. Al-khawf, they say, al-ladhina qala lahumun nasu. إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَأَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. التوكل الخشية. Here they say الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ. إِنَّ النَّاسَ the munafiqun, they're saying to the believers, إِنَّ النَّاسَ the mushrikun, قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ, they have gathered against you. The army is mighty. You're not going to be able to fight against them. And that is what we are faced with today. A lot of people will gang up against the truth. And then someone will tell you that, just forget about it. You have a lot of enemies for standing for the truth. A lot of people are scheming against you. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمَ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَاكْشَوْهُمْ. Therefore, fa'un sababiyyaku, because they have gathered against you, fakhshawhum, fear them. But we say the fear is for Allah alone. Because these were the best of believers ever raised on the face of the earth. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What did that do to them? Instead of them to be afraid of this army that has gathered against them, fazadahum imanan. They told them this to make them to be afraid of the enemies. But that did the reverse. It increased their iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. And they said, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Allah is sufficient for us. And excellent is Allah as a disposer of our fear. So we're not afraid of this army that's gathered against us. We rely on Allah, and it's an excellent disposer of our fears. So you can see that is iman. The enemy was meant to strike fear in the heart of the believers, but that increased them in iman. الَّذِينَ يُبَلِّغُونَ رِسَالَاتِ اللَّهِ وَيَخْشَوْنَهُ وَلَا. They fear only Allah. The Anbiya. وَالْإِنَابَةُ الْإِنَابَةُ بِمَانَا repentance. Repentance, as Allah said in Surah Az-Zumar, we're going to in details. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. وَأَنِيبُوا. In another place, وَأَنَابَ إِلَيْهِ ثُمَّ أَنَابَ إِلَيْهِ أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, right? الْإِنَابَةُ, turning back to Allah in repentance. وَالْإِسْتِعَانَةُ, الْإِسْتِعَانَةُ, That is seeking isti'ana. So seeking for what? Seeking assistance. Which is the best translation? Seeking for assistance or seeking assistance? When you are seeking, you are already full. So if you off something, you don't if it. What of if? I'm trying to remember my English language, my English classes. So they say you don't say what of if. If you have off something, you don't if it again. What of so so and so? What if this happened? But you don't off something and if it again. So perhaps similarly, seeking talab, seeking assistance, right? Al-isti'anatu, seeking assistance from Allah. We're going to listen to this in details. We're going to explain, inshallah, because you have two types of isti'ana, seeking assistance. The one is madhmoon. The other one is what? Mahmood. The other one is blameworthy, and the other one is praiseworthy. The blameworthy one in this circumstance can lead to shirk.
Yeah, it can.
The praiseworthy one affirms tawheed. The praiseworthy one, Mahmood, affirms tawheed. Madhmum, the blameworthy one, takes one to shirk. Al isti'ana, to seeking assistance. So you have to be on ground when we are discussing that one. We're not going to discuss it now. Alaysa kadhalik, al-isti'adhatu, seeking refuge. Refuge. So you are in trouble, you are seeking refuge, right? Refuge. From refugees go. You're seeking shelter. Refuge. So al-isti'adhatu, qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq. You are seeking refuge. Only Allah. So you are seeking for refuge as an act of ibadah. Wal istighathatu. Al istighathatu is asking for, yes, asking for what?
Yeah, it's like seeking for help also.
Asking for help.
This one, it is more serious.
Seeking assistance. Asking for help. Al-isti'anatu. Yes. Astaghfirullah. May Allah protect us, and may Allah bring those kidnapped back to their loved ones. So they are in a situation of seeking for istighatha. They're seeking for help, urgent help. And isti'anatu, you could just be in your house chilling and you're seeking for Allah's assistance to help you in what you want to do tomorrow. But al istighathatu, you're seeking for that help now because you are in trouble. You don't call on anyone but Allah. Again, two types. Madhmuma, al istighathatu, ta'ul marbut ko. Al istighathatu, madhmuma, okay, mahmuda. وَالذَّبْحُ الذَّبْحُ sacrifices يَنْكَمَ الذَّبْحُ وَالنَّذْرُ النَّذْرُ making oaths تُرَنْشِنْ لِيبَاكَ بَا oral English مُكِيَا نَمْبَا oaths النَّذْرُ بَاكَنْشِ vowing. Yufuna bin nadhr wa yakhafuna. Allahu Akbar. Quran is beautiful. Yufuna bin nadhr wa yakhafuna yawman kana shar'u mustaqira. The day whose evil is widespread. Allahu Akbar. Beauty upon beauty. Al-Quran al-Kareem. May Allah brighten our lives with the light of Quran. أليس كذلك؟ وغير ذلك من أنواع العبادة التي أمر الله بها And other than these that have been mentioned of the different types of worship, التي أمر الله بها, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why not الذي? Ta'un al-ibada, ibadatu. Yes, التي أمر الله بها, بها كلها, ha. All of it, لله تعالى, is for Allah the Most High. All acts of worship aforementioned and those that were not even mentioned by Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, لله تعالى. And this reminds me of the verse of Surah Al-An'am, قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. Why not رب العالمين جر لله لله رب العالمين. Just as you say الحمد لله رب العالمين, but in some other places where it starts alone, where there is no anything that would change its condition, you say what? رب السماوات والأرض, مضاف ومضاف إليه, رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما فاعبده واصطبر لعبادتي هل تعلم له سميا. سورة مريم, أليس كذلك؟ الرب هو المعبود, ما شاء الله. والدليل قوله تعالى, and the evidence for all of these, that all acts of ibadah كلها لله تعالى, is the statement of the Most High, وأن المساجد لله فلا تدعوا مع الله أحدا. وأن المساجد, and the masajid, the mosques, وأن المساجد لله, they are for Allah alone. فلا, لا الناهية, بأنفيه بني آدم, لا الناهية, فلا تدعوا مع الله أحدا. So therefore, فاون إنكو, so invoke not, تدعوا الدعاء, invocation, supplication, calling. أليس كذلك؟ So invoke not anyone, مع الله. So you see, a mushrik is a kafir that associates partners with Allah. A Christian is a kafir that calls Isa the son of Allah. A Jew is a kafir that calls Uzair the son of Allah. أليس كذلك؟ نعم. مع الله. So he recognizes Allah, but he calls on others besides Allah, alongside with Allah. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدَعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. So invoke not anyone, أَحَدَفَ, invoke not anyone along with Allah. Al-Masajid, we're going to understand the wajhu al-istidla, that this verse stands as an evidence for all acts of ibadah. Remember, we say acts of ibadah are divided into badaniya, maliya. We can do subdivision into four, as I've jotted it down here. Al-ibadat arba'a aqsam, four categories. Ibadat badaniya, allati yaqumu biha al-badan, the body is the one that does that act of ibadah. Ibadat mali, innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat, ala the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inna fil jasadi mudghah, wa idha fasada ala wa hiya al-qalb, هي أساس الأعمال. So وأن المساجد, because المساجد As we will see, when it is being mentioned, it can take these 2 minutes. Amakin, places of worship, like, you know, the masjid there, Amakin, places of worship. And also it represents the parts that you use in worshiping Allah. Your body parts. Like at Jabahatu, when you go for sujood. Alaysa kadhalik, like when you sit down, like when you are doing tashahud, your body parts, when you go for ruku'ah, your back, your soul. That is why it's the evidence, the wajul istidlal here, wa anna al masajid lillahi fala tad'u ma Allah al du'a also. And then al masajid also. So all categories of ibadah, al masajid, it could be when you use your hand to feed, right? Fi sabilillah. You use your legs to walk to the masjid, to do safa al marwa, sa'i, bayna safa wal marwa. Faman, alaysa kadhalik, are you with me?
No.
Faman sharafa, how many more minutes? Oh, we just started 6 minutes into it. Go. Inshallah. Once we are 50 or so. Faman sharafa minha shay'an li ghayri Allah fa huwa mushrikun kafirun. Faman sharafa minha shay'an ashgarun nakira. Shay'an, wallahi, da kace don Allah don annabi in kana sane kuma an ga maka shirka ne wallahi sai ka fita daga musulunci don Allah don annabi don Allah kai kake fadi just say because of Allah say because of Allah and his messenger if you study kitab al-tawhid which inshallah later on we are going to do here you know we'll take the silsila now the series of the kutub of Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahab after this we will do al-qawaid al-arba'a. We should have started with that one. Then we'll do this. Then we'll do that. Then we'll do that. And also Kitab al-Tawheed, Masail al-Jahiliyyah also, inshallah. Some might just take us few classes. But inshallah, we will make sure we do the silsila, the series of this kutub. And Dammaj in Yemen, you know, is one of their, they take that also, the series of teaching this kutub. From this to the next one, inshallah. فَمَنْ صَرَفَ مِنْهَا شَيْئًا لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ مُشْرِكٌ كَافِرٌ So whoever, فَمَنْ فَاوَنْ إِنَّ فَقُرِنْغَ كُلَارَشِ So whoever, why is there فَاوَنْ here? Simply because you have already preceded it with an evidence, a verse from the Quran, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ You have already said it's for Allah. Therefore, that is fa'un. Faman sarafa minha shay'an. Because you have mentioned all of these acts of ibadah, and then you have told us that these acts of ibadah are for Allah alone. Therefore, consequently, faman sarafa minha shay'an. Whoever directs any part of this, yani. Acts of ibadah, worship. لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ To other than Allah. لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ They were supposed to be directed to Allah, but you directed to other than Allah. فَهُوَ مُشْرِكٌ Such a person is a polytheist. كَافِرٌ A kafir. Now, this also tells us that there is difference. هُنَاكَ فَرُقٌ بَيْنَ الْكُفْرِ وَالشِّرْكِ Kufr, Millah, Wahid. It's one Millah. Islam is one Millah. And then Kufr entails all of these things that we have mentioned. We are reiterating here. These words are not just placed out of the blue. There is a purpose for saying, Wa mushrikun kafirun. Now, after recognizing that only Allah deserves to be worshipped and all these acts of ibadah to be directed to Allah, then you decide to give it to other than Allah. You have recognized that there is Allah. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْفَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ Not that they don't know there is Allah. They know that there is Allah. But after that, they are now sharing the acts of ibadah that are meant for Allah alone, to other than Allah, as did some, as those, yani, as do some people today in our midst. May Allah protect us. Calling on others besides Allah. Seeking for assistance from others besides Allah. And then in the name of ibadah, so someone asks them to bury animals alive because of what you want of this dunya. And then it tells you that it's ibadah, it's Quran that they're going to read. That's taken someone to shirk outside the fold of Islam. A lot of wealthy people, a lot of people with power or in position of authority are being misled by people that are after money and after their own and these other people's destruction, because they are agents of Satan. لَأَحْتَنِكَنَّ ذُرِّيَّتَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. He made a promise that is going to mislead the progeny of Adam, except a few. إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ. You have no authority over my servants, Allah said. عِبَادِي is choosing servants. So it's always good for us to ask Allah, اللهم جعلنا من عبادك الذين اصطفى. Put us from amongst your choosing servants. So a lot of these things are happening there in our midst. Millionaires, billionaires have been made to become mushrikun, all in the name of seeking for the things of this dunya. They are politicking. Someone asks them to bury someone alive, to kill something alive. And then it comes to them as though it's representing Islam. So they even find it difficult to understand whether this is shirk or not, because they see it coming from someone they see as a religious figure or someone that is supposed to guide them to Islam. Or perhaps they even know that then these people keep convincing them that it's seeking, it is not haram. We're using verses of the Quran. Today, a lot of people, millionaires, billionaires, and then even poor people that want to be rich, all caught up in this satanic web of shirk, seeking for the things of this dunya. So you win an election, the success, you place it on what? Your fortune teller. Because he has made you to do certain things. Then you are occupying certain position now, then you are subservient to some riffraffs in the society because you believe they were the ones that made you to be in that position. Some riffraffs, so they dictate to you. You can be a very powerful person in the eyes of the people in the society, but you have one riffraff that is controlling your movement because ab initio, he has made you to believe that he is the one that made you to attend that position. So outwardly, people see you as a powerful individual, but you are the weakest of people. Da'afa talib wal matlub. So these are the type of things we need to be teaching and we need to be reiterating, because a lot of people, willingly or unwillingly, are submitting to shirk in their desperation to get the things of this dunya. Al-malu wal-banun zinatul hayat dunya. والباقيات الصالحات نمشي فمن صرف منها شيئا لغير الله فهو مشرك كافر. You now understand who? Because a mushrik is a kafir, a Christian is a kafir, a Jew is a kafir, a Hindu is a kafir, a Buddhist is a kafir, an atheist is a kafir, a Shintoist is a kafir, a Scientologist is a kafir. Kufr is the umbrella body that carries all of them. Disbelief. What dalilu qawlu, and this disbelief means you have disbelieved in the oneness of Allah, you have disbelieved in the messengership of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Khalas. Oneness of Allah, disbelief that only Allah should be worshipped. Messengership of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have disbelieved that you can only worship Allah through the ways that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with. وَاللَّهِ يُعْبَدَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَرَعَ. Allah says the evidence for saying that whoever directs any part of worship to other than Allah is a mushrik, a kafir, is because of the statement of Allah, وَمَنْ يَدَعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ لَا بُرَهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ فَإِنَّمَا حِسَابُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَىٰ آخر. And whoever invokes along with Allah إِلَاهًا آخر, any other god, لَا بُرَهَانَ لَهُ, of which he has no any proof. Does it mean that if you go out there and seek for proof, you should go ahead and worship Allah? لَا بُرَهَانَ لَهُ, it means there is no any evidence whatsoever to worship others besides Allah. It's not telling you that you should go out there and seek for evidence that will justify your shirk, as some people are doing today. La burahana lahu, ay bi ma'ana, there is no any evidence whatsoever to justify worshipping others besides Allah. But the only evidence present is for you to worship Allah alone. Wa fi kulli shay'in lahu ayatun tadullu ala annahu wahidu. Kayfa yu'sa al-ilah? أو كيف يجحده الجاهل وفي كل شيء له آية تدل على أنه واحد. In everything there is a proof and evidence pointing towards the oneness of Allah. Whatever you look at, whatever, be it yourself, وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون, in yourself, won't you see? Look at yourselves. أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبْلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ وَإِلَى الْأَرْضِ. Look at everything around you. وَفِي الْأَرْضِ آيَاتٌ لِلْمُوقِنِينَ وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Hence, وَفِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَهُ آيَةٌ تَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ وَاحِدٌ. Look at the universe. If you look at the sun, it points towards the existence, the oneness of Allah. Because if there had been more than one Allah, the sun would not rise tomorrow, because the other god would say, I don't want it to rise today. So in the rising of the sun and the setting of the sun, it's a pointer towards oneness of Allah, which means only Allah should be worshipped. وَالسَّمَاءِ ذات الرجعي. Allah took an oath with the heavens, the sky. ذات الرجعي, the one that brings them down, that brings rain down again and again. ذات الرجعي, again and again, again and again, the rain keeps falling. This also is a pointer towards the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence, He alone should be worshipped. When you look at every human being, except for those that Allah has created with certain defects, but the anatomy of human being is the same. Dissect a human being into two parts. What you find on this part, you find on the other part, right? Part mostly, right? Yes. At least when you do the anatomy of your physical apparent body parts, the nose has two, the nostrils, right? The eye here, yeah, left and right, this and that, this and that, this and that, divide into two, this and that, right? Divide your lips, and then alongside, look at it, it has divided itself. And then your teeth, 32, 16, 16. Then divide your chest, you have this side, you have that side. The perfection, every human being, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ. Look at your hands, you cut off your fingernail. Cut this side off, you'll not see the finger. You'll not see the root of it here. This one that you are seeing, if you cut beyond this, you won't see this hard surface of your fingernails. Will you see it? Where is it coming out from? The blood depletes and then new ones are formed. The blood cells keep dying and the new ones are being formed. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. أَلَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. As we said in our last class, yusqa bima'in wahid also. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in iman, grant us iman, increase us in it, and then let us die upon iman. There is liberation in Quran and Sunnah, and there is happiness in Quran and Sunnah, and there is salvation in it, and there is contentment in it. There is everything beautiful in it. Allah says, فَإِنَّمَا حِسَابُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ. Then know that is reckoning. Is only in Nama Yufidul Hasar. Is only with Allah. With his Lord go. For innama hisabuhu inda rabbihi. His Lord. Because he has recognized that Allah is his Lord. And then he's a mushrik. Because his shirk now is in uluhiyah. I don't know if you understand. And the Rabbi has recognized that Allah is his Lord. But now he has failed to worship Allah alone. He's now directing acts of worship to other than Allah or alongside with Allah. But the first step is Rububiya, he recognizes. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْفَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا هُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. مَفْهُوم؟ نعم. Allah says, إِنَّهُ غَيْنْدَ الْأَمَرِ يَكِي. Surely, la yuflihu al-kafirun. The disbelievers will never be successful. Will never be successful. And then you want to please them. People that Allah said will never be successful, you want to please. But Allah says, innahu la yuflihu al-kafirun. What did Allah say regarding the believers? Qad aflaha al-mu'minuna. Amma zo da falaha din kafin ma ambaci mu'mina. Qad aflaha al-mu'minuna. Verily, certainly, they are successful. Who? Allah, the believers. But here says, innahu la yuflihu al-kafirun. Now, what they did was shirk, but Allah calls them kuffar. Because shirk is shrinked into kufr. What they did was shirk. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا. They are calling Allah, but they are calling others besides Allah also. That is shirk. Then at the end of it, Allah says, إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. May Allah protect us. وَفِي الْحَدِيثِ. In the hadith, الدعاهُ مُخُ الْعِبَادَةِ. InshaAllah, I think we're going to stop here. Cool. Ad-du'a'u, we have 7 more minutes to reach 1 hour. So let's just discuss this hadith. Ad-du'a'u mukhul ibadah. The hadith of Anas bin Malik. But this hadith is not authentic. They have a lapse. Ad-du'a'u mukhul ibadah. Yani, saying that, yani, ad-du'a is what? Is the core, muh, this loves, muhul ibadah, is the core of supplication. This narration is the narration of Anas bin Malik, attributed to Anas bin Malik from Anas, is in the Sunan of Abu Isa al-Tirmidhi, but the narration has been declared as weak by Sheikh Nasir bin al-Albani, Sahih, it's in Sahih Targhib, also in Sahih Sunan al-Tirmidhi, that the hadith is not authentic. What is authentic is what? Ad-du'ahu huwa al-ibadah. Ad-du'ah is the essence of ibadah. Kawai, kama achi maka al-hajj al-arafa. How did the narration come? Now, the Prophet said, Arafah is hajj. It doesn't mean that all other manasik of hajj, if you just stand on the place of Arafah, you have done it. But it's telling you it is the essence of it. It is the main essence of it. So, Ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah. This narration of Nu'man is the narration of Al-Nu'man bin Bashir. The other one, Ad-du'a hu mukh al-ibadah, Anas bin Malik in the Sunan of Abu Isa. Tell me, it is not authentic. Alaysa kadhalik. And that is why in Majmul Fatawa of Sheikh bin Baz, he brought the other one, Ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah, of the narration of Ad-Nu'man bin Bashir. It's also in Imam Shawkani's Fatul Qadir. Now, and then it has been declared as authentic also. So الدعاه هو العبادة أليس كذلك؟ نعم. والدليل قوله تعالى وقال ربكم ودعوني أستجب لكم إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين. وقال even in the hadith of النعمان بن بشير إمام الشوكاني حزيت الفتح القدير ابن ماجه حزيت إمام الترمذي حزيت Abu Dawood, I think, also has it. The narration, the Prophet also recited this verse. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ دَعَوْنِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ Your Lord said, أَدْعَوْنِي أَيْسْأَلُونِي أَوْ أَعْبُدُونِي Worship me or call on me. This gives us the two types of what? Ibadah. The types of dua. Ad-du'a'u, du'a'u, du'a'u, mas'ala. Lakuma du'a'u, ibadah. Ud'uni ay is'aluni, mas'ala. Ud'uni, ibadah. Du'a'u, ibadah. Am I communicated? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam read this. So, let me explain briefly this in the next 3 minutes. الدعاء من العبادات الجليلة التي حث عليها الشرع ورغب فيها. الدعاء is one of the most venerated acts of ibadah. الجليلة, one of the most venerated acts of ibadah. التي حث عليها الشرع, which Sharia has urged us towards. We have been encouraged, we have been urged to call on Allah. إذا سألك عبادي أني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعاني فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون ورغب فيها. We have been made to long for it. وفيها يكون العبد قريبا من الله تعالى. By it the servant becomes close to Allah with ibadah, with dua. You gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَفِي الدُّعَاءِ يَكِفُ الْعَبْدُ بَيْنَ يَدَيِّ اللَّهِ In dua, when you are calling on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either dua'u ibadah, whether you are saying subhanallah, or whether you are saying Allahumma ghafirli, Allahumma rizuqani, يَكِفُ الْعَبْدُ The servant is placed, the servant stands between بَيْنَ يَدَيِّ اللَّهِ He stands in front of his Lord. Sa'ilan, asking hajatahu, asking Allah for his needs. Ya Allah, do this for me. Ya Allah, only Allah can be directed. This act can only be directed. Oh Allah, do this for me. Sa'ilan hajatahu, asking Allah with respect to his needs. Mutawassilan ilayhi bi asma'ihi wa sifatihi, and seeking for tawassul to Allah using his beautiful names and attributes. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدْعَوْهُ بِهَا الدُّعَى فَدْعَوْهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ سَيْجِزَوْنَا إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. So he say, يَا رَزَّاقُ أَرْزُقُنِي يَا رَحْمَنِ إِرْحَمِنِ. Allahumma innaka afoon tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. That is it. Using the beautiful names of mutawassilan ilayhi bi asma'i wa sifatihi, mutawajjian ilayhi bi qalbihi, while you are turning to Allah, facing Allah with your full heart, in full concentration, not divided. You are concentrating while asking, as if we are learning the etiquettes of seeking for Allah's assistance. You are absolutely concentrating. Your heart is completely focused on asking Allah. You are not thinking of other things. You are in front of Allah. بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ سَائِلًا حَاجَتَهُ مُتَوَسِّلًا إِلَيْهِ بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ مُتَوَجِّيًا إِلَيْهِ بِقَلْبِهِ مُثْنِيًا عَلَيْهِ بِلِسَانِهِ While he's praising Allah with his tongue. يَا حَيُّ يَا قَيُّومُ يَا ذَا الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ يَا سَمِيعَ الدُّعَاءِ Etiquette of seeking for dua. La wasita. There is no any go between. There is no anyone between you and Allah. بينه وبين الله عز وجل. There is no شيء. There is no any wali between you and Allah. There is no Inyas. There is no Abdul Qadir Jilani. There is no Tijani. There is no any Khalifa between you and Allah. Not even a prophet. Not an angel. Not to talk of fellow human beings. أليس كذلك؟ وفي هذا الحديث, in this hadith, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الدعاء هو العبادة, أي من أجله تكون العبادة. Through invocation, it becomes عبادة for you. لأن العبد في دعائه لربي يكون معترفا بكمال ربوبيته وألوهيته. So I think we're going to continue. It's 1 hour exactly now. 1 hour, 1 minute. Inshallah, we're going to stop here and then we will continue next week, inshallah, God's willing. Subhanakallah, wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.